What we have here is a Telewave TWPC-1505. TWPC is Telewave Pass Cavity. You notice there's two cables and connectors. There's two loops in this particular kind of filter. This is a tuning rod for the basic frequency. These screws loosen so you can adjust the insertion loss here. And it's more or less calibrated. It's you determine this using the spectrum analyzer as to what the loss is. The first thing I do when I'm going to tune a new cavity that's already pre-tuned somewhere is I find out where it's tuned. I've set the center frequency at 160 here and the span at 40 megahertz, or I've alternately, you can start at 140 and go to 180. And same thing. So there's where we're resonant. This is 160 where the marker presently is. We'll hit the peak here and it says, oh, we're at 148.000, which is the lower edge of this particular cavity, the TWPC-1505. Now, this is misleading. It doesn't have that much loss. That's probably the tracking generator output level, plus the loss of these cables. And that's why we have to normalize this to proceed further. However, right now, what we will do is we will move this to the desired frequency of 155.000. Since I'm going to be moving fair distance, I'm using a drill motor, which I'll show you in a minute, and running this thing up in frequency, closing in on 145. What we'll do is put this peak to continuous peak, and that way it'll tell us when we get there. So we've overdone it a little bit, so I reverse the drill. And then we'll get the rest of the way by using a wrench. Let us put our center frequency peak over in the center here, which is easily done on this machine. We're going to marker to center frequency. Now it's in the center, 155.000. So that's what we want. And right now we're looking at 40 megahertz, but we want to get that a little bit more refined than that. So let's change the span from 40 to 10 megahertz. Well, let's make it 20 megahertz. So that gives you a pretty good idea where the skirts get down here on the edges, and puts us right there in the center of the screen. I've taken a return loss bridge here that I got off eBay. It has 40 dB of return loss. And I put the test cable here that's going to go to the bandpass filter. I've left the end open so that we have an open circuit. And this cable comes from the tracking generator. This cable comes from the input to the spectrum analyzer. I then connect this cable to the input and a precision dummy load on the output here. This is, again, one I got off eBay for about $20. It's good up through 1500 megahertz, so that's good enough for what we're doing. Using the return loss test setup, what I've done here is added a second trace, the blue trace here, which is number 3, actually. I didn't use 2. And what I did is equalize, or shall we say, normalize that, and then check the return loss, which you can see with marker number 4 here, is minus 26 dBm, or dB, actually, that is. So it's about 26 dB down from the level we have near the peak here. The peak here is a little off center, but that's where everything lines up. And it's still good enough. It's minus 1.63 dB and 155 on the peak, the yellow trace. And the blue trace is the return loss, which is minus 26 dB, which is quite fine. Anything below 17, which is the green line, is fine. So the unit is tuned. Sometimes you have to jockey a little bit on the tuning and the coupling of the loops and so forth to get these to line up properly with each other to where the return loss is still over 17 dB or 20 is a pretty good goal, and the peak is where you want it. So that to keep the video short, I'm not going to go through the process of doing all of that because it takes time, obviously.